What is lumbar discectomy? An incision is made just off the midline of the back. For the average size person, the incision is less than 1.5 inches or 3 centimeters, but may be larger for more than one disc removal. Care is taken to preserve the posterior spinous ligament and minimize stripping of the multifidus muscle attachments. Muscles are gently retracted to allow visualization of the bony covering or lamina and the ligament that covers over the spinal canal or the ligamentum flavum. The term microdiscectomy can also describe the smaller incisions utilized with magnification. Microdiscectomy is the standard in most communities. Depending on the level, some of the bone will need to be removed to allow access. Tools including burrs, kerosene punches, and curettes aid in the removing of the covering bone and ligament. The nerve sac is then identified and protected. The nerve sac and nearby nerves are gently swept off the offending disc material. Disc herniation is then removed and the nerve is now freed of pressure. Associated bone spurs may also be removed. This is a general animation of the lumbar microdiscectomy operation, and you should discuss your individual concerns with your individual surgeon. For the properly selected patients without any other medical issues, the success rate of improvement is greater than 90%. For the vast majority of patients, they can resume normal activities within a few months. Most patients now have the operation performed on an outpatient basis. For the properly selected patient, few will ever need additional surgery on that disc level. Remember, surgery is indicated when you have failed non-surgical treatments, have corresponding physical exam findings that match the testing, and you have significant pain that is no longer tolerable. This is Dr. John Shim, and I hope this video helps you understand the lumbar microdiscectomy surgery. If you'd like more information about similar topics, please subscribe to our newsletter or our YouTube channel.